Hey everybody, it's Carol with Refunction Crafts again, and I'm here to bring you one more tutorial today. I already did one this morning and wanted to get this other one done because I'm super excited about these little tins and the practicality of them and what they can be used for. And I think you guys are really, really going to love these. And I'm going to grab one that's already finished so I can show you once again what I do with these little tins. This is the tin that I'm going to be working with today. It's a tiny tin. It's about 1 3/4 inches this way and about 2 1/4 inches this way. And it's a hinged tin, so it has the hinge on the back. And it's just a teeny tiny one. There's a lot you can do with these, but they work especially well for pillboxes. And what I've done in the past also is I have made these to be hanging locket tins. And again, for the purpose of keeping your pills or some money in the locket so that if anything happens, you're wearing it on your person. They come out really, really cute. And in another video, I will show you how I do the lockets. But for this video today, I'm just going to make the pill tin. So these are some of the items that I'm going to be using for this. I've already decided what I want it to look like. But real quick, this is one that I have already completed. And it's super cute, and it just opens like that. And it has a snap-on lid. It closes real easily, and it doesn't open, you know, too easily. It's got the little latch there. So this is one that I've already completed. This one is actually in my Etsy store now for sale. But these things are amazing. They're really something really nice for, you know, if you're thinking about getting something for your mom or your grandma or your sister, someone who has to keep their pills with them. It's a nice gift for that person so that they, you know, have something nice that they can pull out and keep their pills in their purse. And when I sell them, I always put my pill tins in these little organza bags. So that's what they come in from my shop. But I'll leave that one there so that you guys can see what it looks like. And now I'm going to get started on this one, and it's going to be just a very simple process. One of the first things that I'm going to do is I'm going to put this piece of my scrapbooking paper on the top of this just to kind of give it an added look and added dimension so that it's a little more interesting. And then the way that I'm going to adhere that to the tin is I'm going to use glossy accents. And the reason I'm using this is it's a very strong, I use this for several purposes actually. I use it on top of things that I want to get a nice shiny glossy finish to, say images when I do a finished piece like a compact mirror or whatever that I'm just want to have a super shiny finish to, I use this for that too. So it works for a lot of purposes, but for today I'm going to put that on the lid. And make sure when you're working with something like this that has a hinge that you remember what direction you want your pieces to fall in on the top in the end when you have the completed project. One of the biggest problems that I have had, and I do this to myself, is putting things on upside down, and then when I go to look at the finished product and open it, I realize I've put the images and the pieces, the embellishments on the wrong way. And there's nothing more frustrating than that, I gotta tell you. Okay, so I've got my glossy accents on top. This is the front side of the tin facing me here. So I'm gonna lay this piece of scrapbooking paper on top. And it's going to adhere fairly quickly in the very beginning because it's glossy accents. It will be slippery and you'll be able to adjust, but it's not going to give you a lot of adjustment time. just know that that when you're using the glossy accents, it's more like it's almost like super glue in a sense. And I don't know if you all know this, but sometimes you can use super glue or adhesives that are similar to super glue to add a shiny finish to items. People use it in woodworking. My husband uses an adhesive called CA glue, and to me it feels pretty much like super glue. Dries really fast like super glue does, not quite as fast, but almost. And he uses it to put a gloss finish on his pens and pencils when he turns them on a lathe. So just a little FYI, that's something that it can be used for. Now, that's on there pretty darn good. It's not going anywhere. I like to try and make sure that I get my edges pressed down really well, because that's where it's going to come up. But I think on the top of this one also, I'm going to be adding some triple thick and some diamond dust. So we're not going to worry too much about that. The next thing I am going to do, though, is I am going to put some rhinestone chain around the outside of this tin, just to add a little bling and a little sparkle. So I'm going to do that next, and I'm just going to add my E6000 around the outside edge of this tin. Trying not to make a mess here. I'm not drawing a very straight line today, but trying to get your line as straight as you can and keeping it more towards the top of the tin. And I need to grab this different. Okay, there we go. And just making sure that you get it around the entire outside of the tin and ready for that rhinestone. Make sure you always close your E6000 in between uses, especially when it's going to be sitting for a few minutes before you're going to use it again, because otherwise it will ooze out and get everywhere. So I'm going to take this rhinestone chain, and I want it to face up the same direction that you're looking at these diamonds. I want you to be looking at the rhinestone on top of this chain. So we're going to put it with rhinestones facing up, and making sure that you're pressing those down on their sides into the E6000 adhesive, and trying to keep them going in a straight up fashion all the way around. Because if you get those rhinestones turned so that they start facing outwards, if you get to the end and you don't realize you've done that, and you haven't made sure that all your rhinestones are facing the same direction, you'll end up short on your piece that's going around the outside of this. Like this, it started to turn, so I had to readjust it and go back and make sure that everything is facing up. And I'm going to check this out all the way around and make sure that all of those rhinestones are facing in an upward direction. And they really do stick rather well, fairly quickly with this E6000. You don't have to worry once you put these on about them slipping all over the place. It's best, especially if you're a beginner, to let it sit for at least a half an hour before you continue on with your project. I've been doing this a long time, so I'm used to being extremely careful around the rhinestone chain so that it doesn't move on me while I'm working. So I generally will keep on going with my projects. But if you're new to this and have some trouble with touching things that you shouldn't touch when you're working on a project, then you should probably wait. So that's what it looks like now. And no problem with the tin opening. It'll still open and close. And once these rhinestones, once that E6000 cures, these rhinestones are not going anywhere. They're not going to come off. They're not going to slip. They're not going to be loose. They're going to stay on there very well, even with using this tin on a regular basis. You don't have to worry about that. I mean, I suppose you don't really want to throw it around and be too rough with it, but these are not going to fall off. You could drop it on the floor, it's not going to fall off. That is not going to cause any problems. So, okay, so we have our rhinestones on there. And again, the opening is facing me in this direction. So what I'm gonna do next is I have this piece that I received from my friend Debbie, and it's just a little flat button type image of a rose. And I have these little silver bezels that I have a whole bunch of, and I'm going to put that rose inside this bezel to give it a little more attractive look. So I'm just going to drop some E6000 in the bottom of this bezel, just like this. Just spread it around a little bit. Don't get it right up to the edges because it's going to ooze once you drop that that rose in there, and it's going to go to the edges, and you don't want it to ooze out of the edges. So that's very important. So now we have this rose inside that bezel, and it fits perfectly. I was so excited because Debbie sent me several items in a package, which it had some happy mail and some items from her store that she sells on Facebook, and this was one of the ones she sent me. And then she had actually made these out of resin herself, and she sent me some of them, and I was so darn excited about it. I've already shown them in one video, but I'm going to show you again in this video how pretty these are. This one is a little angel. This is a circle. I don't have a bezel that this one fits in right now. I'm looking for one, so I will be doing that. This red one is a fairy, super cute. And then we have this blue one that's a butterfly on a flower, and then this rose. And she just did the most beautiful job on these. They're so pretty and so useful. And I have special projects that I'm going to be using these in, and I'm going to be very careful about how much I use them because this is the only one I got like this. But I don't want to use them all up and then have a project that I want to use them in and not have them. So, okay, so the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to put this one on the top of this, off to the side. So it's going to be off to the left side of this piece. And I'm going to, again, take my E6000 and spread a bit on the bottom of this bezel. And I'm also going to take a dot of hot glue in a couple of spots here to get this to just attach until that E6000 dries. So there we have our hot glue. I'm going to put this off to the left-hand side here. Let me make sure I've got it straight before I... There we go. So that you guys can see the way that it's going to go. And then I've got these other two pieces that I'm going to be using. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to be gluing this piece to the side like that, and then I'm going to be adding this rose, which is another resin piece that Debbie made. I'm going to be adding this rose on top of that, and it's going to complete the whole thing. So we need some more E6000 to glue this piece down with. And a little bit of hot glue. We're going to just use a dab. Two dots will do us. And I'm going to put that right to the side of that rose, right there. Oops. Okay, make sure that's pressed in and that it's going to hold. So I'm going to hold it down for a second. And then I'm going to take this rose and I'm going to add some E6000 to that. And another dot of hot glue right in the center there. And we're going to lay that right between the two pieces there. This is beautiful. Oh my goodness, you guys. I'm just holding it down for a minute so that it gets a chance to stick. And there we go. We have a stunning pillbox, but we're not done yet. Got just a little bit more that I'm going to do to this piece, and it won't be long, and we will be done. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to use a little bit of this triple thick, and this is sort of like a resin product that adds a high gloss finish, and we're going to paint that over this top of this diamond paper that we've got on here. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to put a nice semi-thick coat of the triple thick on top here. Normally I don't use a paintbrush to put this on, but I'm putting a slightly thinner coat than I usually do. So I am going to paint it on with a brush. And it's still a nice thick coat though, because what it's going to do is it's going to be the base for the diamond dust that I'm going to put across the top of this. I'm going to sprinkle diamond dust all across the top of this piece to give it added sparkle. Wait till you see the sparkle that you get from that diamond dust. Hopefully you guys will be able to see it well. Unfortunately, with these cameras that we all have for YouTube, they don't pick up a sparkle really well. So I have trouble with that, and it can be a little bit frustrating sometimes. Okay, I just moved my rhinestone chain a little bit, so let me get that adjusted and back in place. That's very important. Okay, so I have a nice coat of triple thick on that. And next I'm going to take my diamond dust. And what I'm using now, normally I use Twinklets brand diamond dust. But I did buy this on Amazon. It's a different brand than I had ever used before, but it came in this huge tub. This has 14 ounces of diamond dust. And I was going through this stuff so fast that I thought, you know, I need to try and find a less expensive brand. And so I bought this, and actually I really like it. And I'm kind of thinking it might even have a little more sparkle than the Twinklets brand. I'm not sure, but it seems like it's maybe a little bit nicer to work with. So I'm thrilled that I was able to find this for less money and get a lot of it. This jar will last me a long time. So I'm really excited about that. So I'm just going ahead and going around this and just sprinkling this diamond dust all the way around, putting a nice layer of it around the top. And I'm just going to kind of shake it a little bit here. Part of me is thinking, I think I might put a little bit of it also on top of that piece on the rose petals a little bit. Just gonna dab a little bit around on that rose. Okay, again, that was just a little bit more of the triple thick, and then I'm going to add a little bit more diamond dust on top of this rose that's in this bezel. Now, remember, anytime you decide you want to use diamond dust, the only thing about this product, you want to keep it away from children. Number one, very, very, very important to keep this away from children, because this is made up of shards of glass. This is basically glass that's in this bucket. If you feel uncomfortable with using it, don't. Just use some kind of glitter or whatever that you have around that you want to use if it makes you feel safer. Personally, I know that glitter for me does not give the same sparkle that diamond dust does. However, you know, there's always safety to consider, especially if you have kids around a lot and you don't want to, you know, have them get into something like that. And what I do is, you can see, I'm taking and I'm tapping this down so that any shards of glass that might be popping up will be laying down on the piece, and they're not going to be sticking up, and they're not going to cut somebody when they go to touch this thing. But it's so pretty, and the sparkle that you get is amazing. And I don't know if you can see the sparkle on it or not, and it gets even more sparkly as that triple thick dries. The sparkle gets even more intense, and I've got a piece of glue string right there. So that's what it looks like. And I know you can see some of the sparkle from the diamond dust there. I can see it in the lens, so I'm assuming you guys can see it too. But that's what it looks like. I guess that's as good as it's going to get today, guys. But anyway, so there's your little pill tin. Fits nicely in the palm of my hand. And it's super pretty, super cute. You can't go wrong with this as a gift for mom or grandma or sister or someone who has to take pills on a daily basis and needs something to carry them around in. This is super pretty. And it's a very elegant gift to give someone. This will be going into my Etsy shop later on today. I have to snap some pictures of it and so forth. But it will be going into my shop, and it will be available for purchase in case you're interested. One of the other things that real quick I want to show you guys, and I didn't show you in my other video, I just finished some resin pieces, and I just put these in my Etsy shop, and I just wanted to show you because I bought some dried flowers, some new dried flowers. I had made some of these in the past, and I bought some new dried flowers, and I made some more. This is a double keychain. It's two keychains. When they're placed together, they form a heart in the center, if you can see that. And this in the middle here is all dried flowers, dried roses and other types of flower petals and things like that that I've put into them. This set is absolutely gorgeous. And then I made some handmade dangle charms. So these actually mirror each other. One is slightly smaller than the other. I think they're nice for like a mother-daughter set. In fact, I did have somebody buy a set of these. She wanted to give half to her daughter, and she was going to carry the other half. So there's that one. I'm just going to show you a couple of more that I have done here. And here's another one that I did. And on this one, it's got, I think they're like little, I don't even want to guess. They were little purple flowers, but they almost look more like a greenery effect. And then on the outside, I put a sort of an embroidered or crocheted rose trim. It's more of a lacy effect. So I made that one. Here's another one with the dried flowers, and this one has a rose in it. Isn't that gorgeous? With one of my hand-dyed done dangles. Isn't that beautiful? Oh, I just absolutely love these pieces. This is, again, this is resin. I took clear resin, put them in the molds, and put dried flowers in the resin, and this is what I came up with. So I've been doing some work with resin, trying to play around with it and learn how to use it and all that good stuff. This is another, just a little pendant that I did. And then what I did was I did some feathers. This, I need to put this on top of something white. This is feathers. Whoops. And so it's got blue and purple feathers in it. And then I kind of added some embellishments. You can see they're peacock feathers. Isn't that gorgeous? And then I'll show you a couple of other ones that I really have not done anything with yet. I'm just still kind of working on them. Here's a couple more that I poured with more of the blue feathers and so forth, but this is more feathers. So these are going to be coming soon to my Etsy shop. And what I do when I make these resin pieces is I generally put a couple aside to give away as free gifts with purchases in my Etsy shop. So a couple of really lucky buyers have actually gotten one or two of these. Usually the smaller ones I save for gifts to give away, because whenever you buy something in my Etsy store, I always give a free gift every single time without fail. I will always provide a free gift with purchase. So just so that you guys know, I'm pretty generous that way. That's something that I did from day one in my Etsy shop because I thought it was just kind of a nice touch and a nice thing to do. So, and then this is another of the heart set that comes apart. I will be making keychains or purse charms out of this set too, but this set is in the feathers. Super duper pretty. Anyways, I really appreciate y'all for watching and subscribing to my channel. If you haven't already subscribed, I would greatly appreciate it. If you like my channel, if you would go ahead and subscribe. I will be doing another giveaway once I reach the 2,000 subscriber level. Right now I'm at 1600 and something. I'm not quite sure exactly what the number is, but we're headed towards 1700, so that leaves another 300 subscribers that I'm going to need to get in order to do that next giveaway. And I do give away nice things, just so that you know. I don't give away cheesy items. So once that time comes around and we reach that 2,000 subscriber mark, I will do a video tutorial of whatever it's going to be as far as my giveaway item, and so that you'll know right up front what you're reaching for. If you don't like it, you may not want to subscribe, but I doubt that that'll happen. I will make sure that I make something really, really incredibly nice, and something that anybody could enjoy having themselves or giving to someone else as a gift. So I'll be working on that, you guys, and hope that you'll stick around and wait for me to hit that 2,000 subscriber mark. And then again, I will be doing a video to explain the rules and how it's all going to work, and how you can win. And we'll just go from there. But I really appreciate y'all being there. Thanks for hanging out in there with me. And let's help grow this channel so that I can get more tutorials out to everybody. And if you have any suggestions on things you would like me to do, I will be doing a tutorial on how to do these resin pendants. I'm going to try and do a resin tutorial. It's going to be a little bit out there. Not too far off, but I've been trying to get comfortable with the process, and now that I am, I just have to figure out, you know, there's a lot of dry time in between and things, other things that you have to do with resin that I don't have to do with other pieces in order to, you know, do a tutorial. So I just have to work on that and figure out how the process is going to work. But stay tuned for that. I will be definitely doing a tutorial on the resin. So that's going to be a lot of fun. And thanks for watching, everybody. Have an absolutely wonderful rest of the day. Have a great week. And I will be trying to put out another video. Probably I'm going to try in the next few days. I'm trying to get some extra videos out. I went on vacation last week, had some time off, much needed time off. I know a lot of you know I do take care of my mom. She's got Alzheimer's. And that being said, I've been taking care of her for almost 3 years now. And after a while, this was the first vacation I've had in 3 years. And it was really only 3 days away. My husband and I went to Las Vegas and came back, but thankfully my sister was here for the week, and so we were able to go out and visit the kids and have some other fun at the same time. So we had a really nice week last week, much needed time off, and I'm refreshed and ready to get going on this stuff again. So I'm working on filling up my Etsy shop and doing some YouTube videos. Anyway, thanks very much, you guys. Have a great day, and we'll see you real soon. Bye-bye.